Recitare mentre preso dal delirio non so più quel che dico e quel che faccio, eppure dopo sforzati va.
Well, I wanted to share with everyone this repertoire that I've been singing for the past few years. These are operas and composers that I thought I would never sing, but actually, since I started singing this repertoire, I've been asked to sing in many of the most important theaters in Europe. So recording this disc is sort of like my way to thank Verdi, Puccini, and the other composers represented here. Well, these parts came up, I think, just at the right time in my career. I think I now have the voice, the experience, and the vision of a singer with more than 30 years of career to give these roles much more meaning than I would have had 10 years ago, for example. But I also continue to learn new things day after day with Verdi, Verismo, and French opera. Opera is an infinite process. There's always something new or something more to say. Well, it's funny you should ask that, because I sang Verdi many years ago with smaller regional American opera companies. I was very young, but it was a really fun time. And after that, my career went through Rossini and Bel Canto, and after 25 years of that, I felt that perhaps it was a time for a change, and maybe I should tackle some of the huge Verdi roles. And then came Arrigo. Well, Arrigo in Vespri Siciliani was my first really big Verdi role, and it was in 2011, and I was 57 years old, and Maestro Gianandrea Noseda and the Teatro Regio of Torino gave me this incredible opportunity and allowed me to enter into a new and awesome musical universe.
In my opinion, Greg represents the experience, the wisdom that he has reached through the maturity of so many years of experience in singing and the musicality that he has, because he's a great musician. And to me, is the proof that that assures that a singer with a solid technique can have a long career. To me, is without any doubt one of the best tenors nowadays.
Y el segundo.
Well, Verdi is the opera composer. I think anyone will tell you that. He is the opera composer. His stories and characters still to this day portray the society in which we live. Verdi characters are full of strength and also of poetry and nobility and humanity. Singing Verdi, I think, gets you close to the human soul.
Con calma fronte, era
senior. Well, Otello means a lot. It's probably the culmination of a career in most tenors' experience, and I was able to make a debut of it in the famous La Fenice in Venezia. It was one of the most unforgettable moments of my life, and I also was able to sing it in Palazzo Ducale, at the home of the Lion of Venice, where quite a few historical singers did it as well, the most memorable being Mario Del Monaco. These moments can justify an entire career. Romeo is sort of a sentimental choice. It's a humble tribute to my first real maestro, Alfredo Kraus, and also a bow to the French repertoire in which I made my European debut. And as an aside, the first time I sang this part, I met my wife, so what can I say? I've sung a lot of French opera, and I've sung it in many, many places all over the world, so I always have to include French opera.
Sai,
allora come sta
lento? Allora come sta scritto?
Verismo, you know, is intensity, and of course there's a lot of singing. But most importantly, there's truth in emotion, real situations. Verismo, I think, should touch your heart. Well, I think Puccini created the roles and arias that every singer wants to sing and dreams to sing. If Verdi represents emotion, Puccini is true passion. With overwhelming music full of colors and contrasts, for me, Puccini is the definition of verismo. Puccini can take you to the Far East, the American Wild West, or the very heart of Rome and Paris, and at the same time, tell beautiful love stories full of emotion. I think it's one of the great opportunities I'll have in my career in these next months, and I'll be able to sing some of the great Puccini roles. I'm sure it'll be very emotional, certainly for me, and I hope it will also be for the audience.
Spazio guardai profondo e ai prati colmi di Terra un immane tesoro.